A very good afternoon to all of you. So, I am once again here, and today I will be discussing what exactly a time variant and a time invariant system is. As the name is self-explanatory, or as the name is self-suggesting, that any input in which any variation in time gets reflected in the variation in the output. If the input is varied, are you getting it what I am telling you? For example, take an example, a layman's language, that if there are two people, okay, one is having an age of 7 and another is having an age of 9. So the difference between the ages of these two people is 2. Okay. Now let us consider this difference as the output. So with time the age will become 10 and the concerned second one becomes 8. Again the age becomes 11 and the second one becomes 9. So can you tell me that with time the difference, the output is varying? No. The input is varying. The age of the two students is varying. Is not at all fixed. But the difference is fixed. So this kind of system is time invariant. It doesn't have any impact of time. Now, sir, what can be a time variant system? This question will arise. What will be a time variant system? So it is very easy to understand a time variant system. The relation of age with height. We can say that if a growing kid is there, okay, as the age changes, obviously we are not incorporating the exceptional cases. Then as the time passes by, the height will also increase. The height will increase. So the height is a time variant function. It is going to vary. But if that particular guy reaches a mature age of 30, then we can be very sure that no, now his height cannot change. The age will change, but the height cannot change. So that becomes a time, obviously, a time invariant system. So now coming back to the mathematical terms, if the input gets shifted by t0, xt gets to x of t minus t0, then this shift should be replicated in the output. This shift should be shown in the output. It means output becomes y of t minus t. I think I am very much clear till this point. Okay. Now, so this system, when y of t minus t naught becomes equals to x of t minus t naught, then the system will termed as time invariant. Else, the system will be termed as time variant or variable, a system which varies with time. Have a look at this system. Yt equals to tx of t. If we are looking at yt equals to tx of t and we vary x by t minus t naught, so xt gets varied by x of t minus t naught. What about y of t minus t naught? Y of t minus t naught, then that t minus t naught gets replicated in t. So the output becomes t minus t naught x of t minus t naught. This is the output corresponding to a shifted y of t minus t naught is t minus t naught x of t minus t naught. Whereas the shifted inputs looks like this. Okay, the shifted input will be t x of t minus t naught. So now we can very well check that whether y of t minus t naught is equals to the shifted input, and we can come straight away come to the conclusion that no, it is not happening, it is not equal. Okay, now come to yt equals to x of 2t. If we are looking at yt equals to x of 2t, then again shift the input. So in input, the input gets shifted by x of 2t minus t naught. Yes, be very sure that you are not going to put t equals to t minus t naught. No, the x of t is getting shifted. It means the shift is in the input, so it will automatically become x of 2t minus t naught. Whereas in yt, you can very well see in y of t is nothing but y of t minus t naught. That comes out to be x of 2, and instead of t, it becomes t minus t naught. Then it's clear. This is your, so this becomes x of 2t minus 2t naught, and this is time variant. I think I am quite clear till this point. Till this point, there's no doubt. This is a time variant system. Because why I am saying it is time variant system? Because x of t naught, shifted t naught, is x of 2t minus t naught, and when the output is getting shifted, that it becomes y of 2t minus 2t naught. So 1 is not equals to 2, so the system is time variant in nature. Now let's discuss another very good example, that is yt equals to minus infinity to t x tau d tau. Again shift xt by t naught, so this becomes x of t minus t naught, or tau minus t naught d tau. I will put the value in this part. Now please keep tau minus t naught equals to p, so tau becomes p plus t naught, d tau becomes dp. So the limits, what about the limits? We have to take care of this limits also. We can very well see that limits is tau is going to minus infinity, then p will surely go to minus infinity. When tau is going to t, then p will go to t minus t naught. And this operation is shown here. So this is minus infinity, t minus t naught, x p, minus infinity to t minus t naught. Now have a look at this y of t minus t naught. This becomes x of tau d tau, and tau is varying from minus infinity to t minus t naught. So the output is x of t minus t naught equals to y of t minus t naught. You can very well see that this is x of t minus t naught is this thing. This is what we are obtaining as we get to a shifted input. This is nothing but x of tau minus t naught, a shifted input. And you can again come and see to the shifted output. Shifted output, after rearranging the limits, putting the desired values, we are going to get x tau d tau from minus infinity to t minus tau. So both x of t minus tau and y of t minus tau are equal. So the system is time invariant. Now let's take another example. Yt equals to ln x of t. If yt is ln x of t, then you can take yt equals to minus infinity to 5 x tau d tau. We can again check these systems, okay? By this is a very common trend that you have to put tau minus t naught equals to p. Yes, simply replace the variable, then automatically the limits will change. The limits of integration will change, and then check for x of t minus t naught and y of t minus t naught. And if you are receiving the same value, then you can say straight away that the system is time invariant. So thank you for this lecture. I'll see you in the next class. Thank you.